Hi everybody, this is my buddy Tom.
This is Mike.
And together we make poor decisions. Today we got a pretty standard lineup. It's the stuff you can find on any grocery store shelf, liquor store, convenience store, whatever. We're gonna start off with a wild turkey, just a standard wild turkey, nothing special. We have Jack Daniel's number 7, the normal stuff that every college kid drinks, and you know, everybody starts off drinking with Coca-Cola.
Yeah, these are all good mixers. So yeah, we got a 81 proof, an 80 proof, and then the third one here is another 80 proof Jim Beam product. And the last one is the Evan Williams, a heavy hitter at 86 proof. And this is like anyone can go buy this on the shelf, any town in the United States, maybe in any country.
Except for Robbinsville.
Yep. Yeah, let's go ahead and these are blinded to us. We don't know what is in each glass, so we're gonna see which one we like best. Start with A.
A it is.
You know, I haven't drank an 80 proof bourbon since I really started getting into bourbon.
Yeah.
It's been a long time.
You know, I can get some alcohol off here, but not what we normally get with those with those higher proof bottled and bond stuff that we drink. It's disappointing. Is the word. It's
not a lot of flavor there.
Not.
Nice sweetness on the end though.
There's some sweetness, a little bit of leather. Mm-hmm. You know, but I don't get too much fruit or anything like that.
Yeah.
It's just standard. I mean, standard, I guess it would be
bourbon.
Good with Coca-Cola.
Good mixer.
Also, not a lot of nose going on here. It's just
not a lot of oak.
Okay, that's a way different flavor.
Some more rich, deeper oak flavor than that first one.
Yeah, and again, I haven't drank any of these in forever.
I almost want to say like it's almost a nutty kind of flavor on that one.
Sweaty gym socks.
Fresh tennis balls.
Yeah. Hey, don't touch them up. I don't even play tennis. You getting anything at all? Okay, this one has a different drink to it than the other ones. There's definitely flavor that's coming through. I'm getting some cherry here.
The nose isn't as good as the other two, but it definitely has like more depth to it than the first two.
In the taste, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I honestly couldn't tell you which one is which one I like better. You know, they're all
okay.
Just
this one. This one's different than all of them on the nose.
But it's very flat in the taste.
Mm.
It's we've been spoiled drinking that Alcan stuff for sure.
It's hard going back to these beginner bourbons.
Again, there's nothing wrong with these. They will get you drunk. But it's like getting a cheeseburger at McDonald's or getting a cheeseburger, you know, in a higher end restaurant. You know, it's gonna be way different. You know, they're both cheeseburgers, they're gonna do the job, but
yeah.
This isn't
this might be like one of the hardest blinds I've ever done.
I don't know if there's anything that I like that stands out that this is fantastic. Oh man. So let me tell you guys about a poor decision.
Here we go.
All right, here we go. So when I was in the Army, there I was. No shit. Thought I was going to die. I had a soldier. I'm not going to mention his name, but it was Perez. And it was a cook. And I was a shift leader in the 82nd. And we were just finishing breakfast. He's got lunch to do. And I take Perez over to the refrigerator, open it, and I put his hands on these two roasts that are in the refrigerator. And I said, this is what we have for lunch. I said, 350 degrees, low fan, right? Salt and pepper, right? Pretty easy.
Simple.
Right? And I said, tell me what I said. He said, salt and pepper, 350 degrees, low fan, 8 o'clock. Got it, Sergeant, right? Or it was Sergeant back then. So I'm like, great, good job. So about 8:15, 8:30, I'm coming through the kitchen, right? Cause we serve them breakfast until 9. And there's the roasts that are sitting out on the counter and they're bright red. I said, Perez, what are you doing? Get these in the oven. Why are they freaking bright red? And I really used a lot of profanity back then more than I do now. It was just pretty interesting. Anyway, so Perez goes, oh, I was about to put those in the oven, Sergeant. And I was like, why are they bright red? He goes, I said, what did I tell you to do? He said, 350 degrees, low fan, 8 o'clock, salt and pepper. And I'm like, why are they red? He said, he used cayenne pepper.
Oh.
Because I didn't specify black pepper. Oh, we washed them off and then re-salt and peppered them and got them back in the oven. But, the lunch was a little late, but that was definitely a poor decision. And I don't know who was making the poor decision, if it was me for not staying on his butt or, trusting him or him not knowing the difference between black pepper and red pepper.
Hey, he did what you told him.
Barely. So. He was still late.
All right. Well, thanks for that poor decision story, and let's get back to tasting and ranking, which I find very, very difficult right now, ranking these. But I know which one's my favorite out of the three already. But the other ones are just like...
I'm just like all disappointed.
Just want so much more from this, but...
From all of them. Yeah, I'm gonna go... with C being my favorite, but to be honest, they're all very close.
So C was my favorite too.
But they are all very close. I just don't know what I like and what. So why don't you
just reveal them. I'm just gonna pick my first because
that's it.
Now.
Okay, taste A is your Jim Beam 80 proof 4 year.
Okay.
Taste B, Wild Turkey, 81 proof.
That's kind of disappointing. I mean, the Wild Turkey 101 is one of my daily sippers.
Taste C is Evan Williams, 86 proof.
Oh, so we picked the one with the highest proof. That's what we like the best.
And Taste D is your Jack Daniels, 80 proof.
Okay. Well, sorry we couldn't rank them other than what our favorite one was. That was just really
They were really all difficult. Just so close.
Yeah.
But it just goes to show, if you're gonna mix it with some Coca-Cola, you're not gonna know the difference between any of them anyway.
No.
Get whichever ones you can get your hands on for the cheapest, just like we used to do in college.
Yeah, they're all great mixers. I wouldn't grab one of any of these off the shelf to drink them neat.
Right. But, I'm not drinking any of them neat.
No, mix it with something. They're all going to give you a good drink.
Yeah. All right, everybody. Thanks for showing up. Like, share, and subscribe. Please share this with your friends and leave a comment. And if you have any poor decisions, why don't you leave those in the comments right here, and maybe we'll feature you on our show as a guest poor decision. I don't know. Figure out what you guys do bad, drunk or not drunk, just stupid things that you've done, like putting dynamite in dog poop or whatever. All right.
Well, cheers, everyone.